I will ask my reader just to open the Bible and I'll begin to read with me. Quick now, just give me a few minutes then and we'll be done. We are already announced everything and now my reader, you are there. And now we are reading from book. We are starting. My message today, I'll be speaking just a few about be committed for a cause. Be committed for a cause. Let me repeat it again. I say the message I'm about to speak to you today is about be committed for a cause. Can you repeat for me, please?
Be committed for a cause.
Amen. Repeat it again.
Be committed for a cause.
When you leave this place and you are going home, I need you to remember one thing. Because sometimes, I can't even prove, you know, I will ask you a question about what was last Sunday that preached, you forget about it. That's why a lot of people in the church, they don't grow. We are not growing, and sometimes we blame the pastor, the leader, that we are not growing, but ourselves, we are not committed for the cause of our growth. Amen. We are not committed ourselves that I decide I want to change my life. I decide I want to grow. I decide I want to become somewhat different and I'm committed to myself for that cause. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Look, I say amen this to the church. Even about when we are speaking about the music industry, today in the music, if even you want to sing well, if you are not committed in practice, if you are not committed in singing by yourself, your life will remain the same. Even me as a pastor, if I'm not committed to the cause which God called me, I want to read my Bible and praying day and night and fasting and seeking the Lord and living the life of the holiness and the life of the fear of the Lord, I will not get anywhere. I will just turn it around and nothing will change in my life. Amen. Come on, somebody. Amen. And today, I want to challenge somebody about your own life. I want to challenge somebody today about your own life and telling you that I want you to be committed for a cause, a perfect cause, which really can help your life to move to another dimension. You know, I want to shock you in the Bible. Since I've been reading the Bible, I never see God calling lazy people in the business. No. God never called the lazy people to be part of his team. And God never called the complaining people to follow him. And God never called excuse people to be part of his business. Most of people God called from Genesis to Revelation, you will find out they were so busy and because of the cause of calling, they stopped what they were doing and they followed the cause God is giving to them. From Genesis, the first person you need to understand, our father Abraham, the Bible says when you are reading from Joshua chapter 24, from verse 4, you will find the Bible says, when God called him, he was serving the God of his father. He was in the business with the father, and suddenly he heard the voice of the Lord, and he had to drop out the business of his father. He said, okay, I'm responding now to your voice now. Amen. And he was committed for the cause which you and I today. We are a Christian and we are able to declare, say, I'm the daughter of Abraham, I'm the son of Abraham, and you are declaring your promise. Why? Because Abraham paid the price for you today. Come on, somebody, amen. If Abraham, he didn't obey God, if Abraham didn't respond to God, you and I would not be the way we are today. Oh, come on, somebody. If Abraham did not respond and obey God and submit himself to the cause of the people of God, you and I will be somewhere else. And most of people of God called, they were busy, but they understand the difference and they accept to make difference in their busy life. Amen. And you know, sometimes in the church, what we found today, the church can be even 10,000, but those who does the thing, they're just them. And some they just come, oh, me, I don't be part of the team, but no, today, you don't just break down a little bit that you are needed by God. Amen. Or come on, somebody. I say, you are needed by God. You just keep on this side. Just become this side. I say, you are needed by God.
Amen.
You are not here by accident, but you are here because God needs you. No, we are about to look in the Bible. And the way we are about to look in the Bible, we are about to look at any church as our model. All the church we are today. Last 2 weeks, we celebrated the Pentecost Day. Amen. You know, when you read from chapter 1, verse 8 of Acts, you found out Jesus is giving them a promise that wait a little bit until you receive the power of the Holy Spirit, then you become my witness. Wait a little bit. And the Bible says all the disciples that come together, about 120 people, they began to pray day and night through fasting. And you just found out most of people Jesus called on that time, they were the business people. Oh, come on, amen. Most of people who followed Jesus on that time, or in the Bible, there were most of them the business. Peter was a business person.
Who knows about that?
He had a fishing industry. He had his own business. John was a business. Andrew was a business. Matthew was a working person in office. Judah was a contact. All of them, when you look in the Bible, you will find most of them, they were busy walking in the life. But when Jesus showed up, said, follow me, and straightway, immediately, they accept to follow Jesus. Now, I've got a question to someone in the house. How many times you are expecting God to call you to follow him? But some people have believed they already be here. God has already called them. He keep repeating, but they never listen. They are still saying to God, oh, you know, I'm very busy. I know. Even myself as a pastor, I can know those kind of people that are here. How about God? Me, I can call my name and say, you are one of them. How about God? He knows you. Come on, somebody. Amen.
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 Now, when we move from chapter 2, was about fulfillment on the day of Pentecost, which you and I, we celebrated. Now, I love about this now. The Bible says, when the day of Pentecost has fully come, and Pentecost was a day of festival of the first fruit in Israel, where all the people are coming together to celebrate it. In the busy time, people are preparing, they are about to, you know, walk around the streets, begin to sing, dress different kind of clothes. People are coming from Ethiopia, people are coming from Syria, people are coming around the world, and all of them are going to Jerusalem to celebrate it that day. And many Jews, they are coming all around the different kind of the world, and they are going on to celebrate it. And suddenly, the Bible says, the sound from the heaven, like a rushing wind, began to move now. Follow me now here now. And suddenly, God drew the intention. They forget about festival, but it becomes the festival of outpouring of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Their objective was about the party, and through their party, God changed the story. Now, the focus of people was out of that event. The neat thing about this, on one day message, 3,000 people that were repentant. How many people supposed to be there? If 3,000 there, 3,000 people that were repentant on that day. One day, 3,000, which means there were many. Come on, amen. There were many of them. And because of that, on one message, the number of believers who respond, there were 3,000. And the change of Jesus started by 3,000 people in Jerusalem. Oh, come on, somebody, amen. The change started by 3,000 members. Those God bring me now to change. Can I say to somebody, you know what I say? I like the church to grow. Can I say to you guys, do you think today, if we have a church of 20,000, 50,000 in Australia, and when they pass the law, which they try to argue now in the parliament about homosexual, I don't have anything against them, but against the spirit which lives beyond them, because they are changing the identity of God. Amen? They are trying to change, which is not good. For them, it's okay. I was in Dubai meeting, and one of the pastors asked me a question, what do you think about this? I said, my answer is only one. I say, if all of us, women to women, they get married, men to men, they get married, how the future will look like? Amen. Think about this. If the men, they get married, women, they get married, the future will look dark. The production will not be there anymore. The production will not be there. We'll not have the children, we'll not have anything, you know, and that's the end of the war. 20, the war is finished. And I said, that's what I know. I would accept it. And I believe myself, if the church today, we are strong in power, we are strong in the word, and we are so radical, and we are growing the church, we'll be able to stand in the parliament and say no. And they won't obey because of the cloud. Come on. You know, what saw my heads. I was watching on the news, and I saw all those lesbian, homosexual, maybe they're following me on YouTube, and they're marching in the city, they're claiming their life, their rights, all because I feel like I'll be married. Like, come on, that's a rubbish abomination. That's abomination in the princess, and they're claiming, and then the children are talking to say, yeah, we need to understand them, they'll make their own choice. What is choice? Bringing evil in the country, and the church, we are sitting quiet, say, we are the church of God. Come on, somebody, amen. We need a church to grow, and a church must go for the goals. Come on, amen. Be able to stand and say, we are the light of this world, and we are standing against anything standing against our kingdom. Amen. The reason why we are here to represent our kingdom. Come on, somebody. Amen. Can I help the church to understand? This, your workplace is your church. Amen. Where you are serving is your church. You are going to represent God's kingdom there. Amen. You are going to represent God's kingdom. Don't be embarrassed to defend your faith. Don't be embarrassed. Oh, I don't want to offend anyone. They're offending you because they're getting married between them. And they are kissing themselves on the streets, men to men. And you said, I don't want to offend them, but you offended because of what you see. Look at you. Amen. Church, we need to wake up now. Church, we need to stop about, oh, me. No. We need to focus about the cause. We have to be committed for the cause of Christ. Amen. When you receive the Holy Spirit, the purpose of the Holy Spirit was not for you that speaking in tongues that make I feel good. When I'm attached to the Holy Spirit, I can speak in tongues. No, when we receive the Holy Spirit, the Holy Spirit will lead us to confrontation of the evil power.
Amen.
You know what I mean? That's it. When we receive the Holy Spirit, the Holy Spirit will expose us to confront the evil power.
Amen.
You don't receive the Holy Spirit and go back home and sit like, hey, I speak in tongues. No. Of course, we need to speak in tongues. But the man told himself that God invests the power because God knows that you become ambassador. And because you become ambassador, you can't work according to your own ability. You need some supernatural power from heaven that you can be able to represent God everywhere you are. You are connecting yourself to the heaven. Oh, come on, somewhere, man. Everywhere you are connecting yourself to the heaven, to the power of the Holy Spirit in your life. How is it here?
Yes, sir.
But you know, today in the church, a lot of people complain. Me this. Hey. Okay. My reader, let's just read from, you know, we're going to read a couple of verses there. Let me see.
The fellowship of the believers. Acts chapter 2, verse 42 to 47. They devoted themselves to the apostles' teaching and to the fellowship, to the breaking of bread and to the prayer. Everyone was filled with awe, and many wonders and miraculous signs were done by the apostles. All the believers were together and had everything in common. Selling their possessions and goods, they gave to everyone as he had need. Every day they continued to meet together in the temple courts. They broke bread in their homes and ate together with glad and sincere hearts, praising God and enjoying the favor of all the people. And the Lord added to their number daily those who were being saved.
Amen. That's it, crazy. No, let us not go. Let me lay some couple of foundation here now. This was after they received the Holy Spirit. This is when they received the Holy Spirit, they were baptized. And the Bible says, let me read with you now. Those are there, you can just put this here and everyone can just see. You can just put this on the screen, please. And everyone can see. This is what my Bible said to me here. Bible said that where they were devoting themselves to the teaching and the fellowship. Now, I just want to try to share with you something here. The Bible said themselves that were so devoted, themselves that commit themselves to the teaching of apostles. Number one, say, those who receive good news, they decide themselves, the apostles that didn't force them for their growth, but themselves that were committed for that cause. They understand the cause and say, because of we understand, we are committed ourselves. They dedicated their life. You know, we have a lot of people in the church. I can say, even 90% of people, they don't read their Bible here. Now, if you're learning your Bible, you know, even though you come here and say, come on Thursday, you have to do this, you can't do it because you're not alive inside of your life. Nothing will stimulate you. You are so empty. Don't let the church become for your life a custom of coming to the church and you are not growing. One day you will stop coming in the church. Why? Because the risen Lord reigns citizens inside of your life. What will make you grow is what you learn here and what you learn from home. When you bring it together, it becomes more effective for your life to stand during the day. Come on, somebody, amen. I will ask you, how many people brought the Bible here? Press your hand. Do not carry the Bible. Can you see? Can I see to some people that use mobile phone as their Bible? But sometimes you think like they are reading it, but they are sending a text message outside. A lot of people, they are in the church, but they are communicating with outside people. What is when? You come to the church, but your mind is outside. The Bible says that we're so committed, another word, themselves. That we're committed, that decide, that understand the cause, and they say, now, I'm giving myself. I want to know more. And I want to grow. Amen. I want to know more and I want to grow. No one thing in our church, the last 2 years, we have had this awesome Bible college here, school, and the training people, you know. You'll find out those we're expecting to respond, they're always busy. I say to somebody, Jesus, when the disciples they come to you, before he commissioned them, he trained them. Amen. He spent with them 3 years of teaching them and preparing them for the good work. Come on, son. Amen. He spent with them 3 years. Can you believe that John the Baptist started the ministry from before Jesus? But even when the disciples come to join Jesus' ministry, they accept being trained again by Jesus. They didn't come to Jesus by saying, oh, John the Baptist said to us like this, how come you are saying like this? No. I'm not John the Baptist. Amen. I'm Jesus. If you are my disciple, you follow what I'm saying to you. Not John now. Come on, somebody. Amen. You get what I'm saying? The training for believer is very important for them to be effective in the ministry and their life. Amen. Amen. I said the training. You know, sometimes we pray, but when we are praying before the word of God, we can be discouraged inside because we think like God is a magician to answer straight away. But when God is not answering the way we thought, we get more confused. Say, I'll be praying. Because there is not seriousness of the word of God inside. That's why the Bible said in the early church, when they were baptized by the Holy Spirit, they didn't stop there. They gave themselves. They were committed. They become the part of the ministry. They become part of the ministry. They say, yes, I want to be part of this cause. I want to be. But can I say to somebody here? Do you know that the people who changed the world, there were 12 of them. Here were more than 12. Come on, somebody, amen. The people who bring the revival in Azusa, there were not more than 20 people. Amen. By two of those people that give themselves for studying the word of God, praying day and night, singing to know God. And the Bible says, today Azusa become a historical city of the world. Come on, somebody. Amen. Can I hear somebody in the church? If, write this, if you are praying God, don't pray God for your problem, but pray God for his problem, then you will meet your problem through praying God for his problem. Amen? Let me repeat it again. If you are praying God, don't keep praying God bless me, God, you know about my business, God, no. Be focused about who God is. When you are praying God for his business, God will look after your business. Amen. Can I repeat it again? When we pray most of the time, we pray God about ourselves. God about my family, nothing is wrong about that. God about my children, nothing wrong about that. But the first cause, began to pray God for his cause to be done, for his will to be done. Because when the will of God is done, you find your will to the will of God.
Amen.
Oh, come on, somebody, amen. You discern yourself. You discover yourself through the will of Father. When Jesus Christ said, Lord, it's possible, but not to me, but let your will be done. And when the will of the Father was done in his life, Jesus let him become better. Oh, come on, somebody, amen. He become more better. And I began to see here, number one, they were committed to themselves to the teaching of apostle. They decide themselves day and night. I can ask you a question here. How many people really, if you do it, praise God, keep doing it. You're not far from the kingdom. But if you've never done it, try to do it. How many people really who spend their time day and night reading the Bible? Don't raise up your hand. Just raise up your heart before God, because God knows your heart. How many people really who enjoy reading the Bible? Who enjoy reading the Bible? That the Bible might change my perception. The Bible might change my life. The Bible might affect the way I think. The Bible might be my life every day. I'm walking through the Word of God. And I'm not compromising what God is saying. No, can I say to someone, we don't pray God for a miracle. Amen. Let this change your mind. I don't want that type of miracle. But we are praying God for the fellowship and for what he has done for our life.
Amen.
Amen. The miracle will come. But if you can't pray God for the miracle, you'll be disappointed. Amen. A lot of people, they are so disappointed because they are seeking God of miracle. But God says, seek me first. If me first, then what you want, you will see it. Can I help somebody? You know, God needs more relationship than a gift. You know, one day, I was so shocked. I was just from the trip, and one of my sons, what? Come with me here. He asked me, you don't bring me any gift? I said, no. He said, forget about it. Then he walked out. Then I called him back, I said, my relationship with you depends upon the gift. But the first, I'm your father. If you see me as a father, then you get your gifts late. But if you're asking me about gifts, forget it. I believe God wants to be a father to us. Then a giver. Give me, give me, give me, give me, give me, give me. I want a relationship. I want to spend time with you. I want to work with you. I want you to be mine. Then everything you need is with me. And what is with me, you'll be yours. Come on, somebody. Amen.
Amen.
And the model of early church, number one, first was God. God was in the center of everything. Let's read it again. The Bible says they give themselves to the teaching of apostles. John Abel said to me, I don't know about your Bible, but mine said to me that. The Bible said themselves to the apostle teaching and the fellowship, to breaking of bread and prayer. They give themselves to apostolic teaching and the fellowship. Fellowship is about one another. Can I suggest about fellowship? The model of every church was about taking care of one another. Amen. Oh, come on, somebody. Amen. I want to help some people here. Can I just ask you to change your way and to repent today? Because sometimes the people you call, they're just the people you call. But some people, you never call them. Oh, come on, somebody. Amen. Come on, somebody. If I'm your brother, You know that you and I are your brother and sister. No matter what color, I can be a black, you know, I can be a yellow, I can be a red person, but as long as you accept the Father who's the heaven as your dad, you become my brother, you become my sister. Oh, come on. Amen. And the Bible says, if really I'm your brother, from the blood of Jesus, I'm more than your biological brother. You people don't understand about us. Read from Galatians chapter 6. You'll find that the Bible says, if I'm your brother, I become more than your biological brother. Why? Because we have a covenant together with you. Amen. At least your brother, if you become a Christ, a Christian, then something's more different. But as long as she's not a, or he's not a Christian, you understand when there's a problem, I'm the first priority than him. So, Pastor Peter, what you're talking about here? I'm telling you about what's in the Bible. Let us be honest. Today, if Pastor Peter comes to you, your brother needs money. He needs like 100. And me, Pastor Peter needs 100. And we're selling it together here. Say, can I have 100? Who's the one to choose? Don't tell me. You know your heart. Amen. Then you can value your Christian walk with the Father. To know really, if truly you know God. And you know who you are before Him. Amen. When your brother comes and shows up and say, hey, this is what I want. And if a brother from the church comes and say, hey, this is what I want. Sometimes we're more concerned. Nothing's wrong about us. Please, don't take it wrong. Nothing's wrong about helping your family. Nothing's wrong about supporting your family. But there's, Jesus said, my brother and my sister, they are those who does the will of my Father. Think about Jesus. His mother, Mary, coming with his brother and sister, they are looking in the street like Jesus was made. And someone said to them, they say, guy, your mother and sister, they are looking at you. And before the people say, hey, what are you talking about? My mother and my sister, they are those who are doing the will of my Father. Joseph was offended because Jesus said, Mary, I told you about your pregnancy. You see now, this young man is saying, I'm not his father because they don't do that in the will of the Father. The will of the Father of Jesus and Joseph was about doing carpentry. Let me reveal to you. Joseph was expecting a boy to be with him about doing a carpentry. And Jesus said, the will of my Father is not speaking to people. You get it later. Amen. Joseph was offended. Now Mary again was so offended. Said, hey, you don't respect me before the people and say, I'm not your mother. Hello? Are we together? Amen. I love this. To understand who you are. That's why the Bible says, read the Bible. Don't compare yourself to anyone. As I just read the Bible and see the way we behave, then you will not lie to your own conscience. You can say, Pastor, I'm okay, but you know yourself and you know that you're a liar. You know and you know that truly you are a liar. Because you are not applying it. Are we together? Let me be a little bit nice to you, okay? Amen. 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 Hallelujah. Amen. I just love you. I don't compromise the truth. You know, my life to you is just to tell you the truth the way it is. Because if I bring all those bone rushing, I cover you, nothing will change. We want to stay true Christian. Those are proof that I hear what I say I am. Amen. I'm not a Christian because we are in the church. In church and out of the church, I still the same person. Come on, somebody. Amen. Come on, somebody. Amen. Be in the church or outside, will not change my life. I still the same person. I'm a Christian. I'm ambassador. I represent my kingdom. In my house, in my workplace, in my study, everything I do, I know myself, I'm living for a cause. Oh, come on, somebody. How are you to get up? How are you to get up? Can I help somebody here? You are loved by God. How to be good for you? Standing before the witches, casting them out. Before the sick people. How to, can you see this? They thought that they are not even able to do those things. They're not able to cast, you know, when you're mad, they only give you drug to sleep. My goodness. I heard, you know, when the spirit began to speak, who are you? My name is Lucifer. Okay? Even the doctor that ran away said, Lucifer, I don't know about this issue. They only tried to fight into him with the body. They're injecting the body drug for the body to cool down. But the spirit never cooled it down by the drug. You people don't understand that some of us are so dangerous people. When the demon sees you, say, hey, leave us alone, no. Amen. But some people, when the demon sees them, say, come again, you will give you the best again. Then we'll tell your pastor. Amen. Hallelujah. I know we made a difference in the church. I think there's some video here. This girl. Good-looking young lady, this woman, a full-on demon possessed. Wow! And began to pray, and suddenly, a girl began to speak a voice of man. My name is Lucifer. Said, Lucifer, what are you doing in the body? This is my body. What do you want? I'm living here. What is the purpose? I just want to live here with her. See my wife, I say, you're a liar. I say, I'm not a liar. I say, you're about to go. I say, no, I'm not going. Now, what do you want to do? Or can we share together? I say, no, we can't share together. You have to go. I say, no, we can share together. I say, okay, I love those sort of things. Because I know the God we serve is a powerful God. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I say, I will show you now. If you don't want to go, we are about to go. Holy Ghost! And people say, fire! Wait. I said, I don't want to waste. Only one thing, you leave the body and go. Amen.
Amen.
And suddenly, she fell and she was delivered. Can I help? No, young people listening here. How to help you? I was reading in the news, I think it was on my page. I don't know if you read about this. It's happened in Kenya. Very sad story. Let me just bring it out here. Very sad story happened in Kenya. There's one of the young girl, she was a student studying in Kenya. And one day, they went out with a boyfriend. And they drank, and then they went to sleep. That young man, he had HIV. And now suddenly, that young girl asked, what you did to me? And she was laughing. And she went to check, found out that she became HIV positive. Now that young girl said, I will kill many people if I can. I was reading it and I cried. He said, I know myself, I'm a good looking young girl, and the men have always attracted me, and I'll make them suffer. That is the level of possession before me. He said, I will make all the men who come close my way to suffer. And I was reading that in uni, she was one of the uni students. She already settled with more than 177 men in uni. Now think about this now. In one uni, she settled with 177. Those people, some of them are married. Now think about this. Those people, some of them, they have their boyfriend or their girlfriend. Now think about this now. How many people now, they will spread their sickness? That's what was in uni. But outside of the uni, she celebrated with more than 200 people already, including the politician. And she was confessing, said, I'm about to make men to suffer. You know, look at the life we are living now. As a church now, if we are not standing and begin to speak the truth, many that will give, they will be dying. Amen. We are here as a church to denounce any wrong behavior that the people of God, they are not protected. Amen. And sometimes the young people, they don't care about that. It's just fun. Sex is fun. You'll finish wrong. Do you know today, according to the statistic of the people who are possessed by the evil spirits, 90% of them, they are young people from 15 years old to 28 years old. Where they get it? Through television. Where they get it? Through alcohol. Where they get it? Through the party. Because their mind is more open about, let me try this, let me try this. By trying it, you are opening yourself. The enemy is taking control of your life. Young people, listen more carefully. Be careful for your future. Don't kill your last 40 years of living by one day and begin to regret and become a dangerous for the community. Like that girl who said, I will make men to suffer. How is it, girl? How is it, girl? Now, let me go quick here now. And this is what my Bible says to me here now. I want to see the church to change. People who are so committed. The Bible says, fellowship of one another. There was fellowship with one another. Not between black and black. No. Can we break this separatism in the church? I see the Lord, when after the service here, you found out just those who speak themselves. Don't come, the new people, they are from their lost in the church. Come on, somebody. Move out and go greet somebody. If today we expect our church to grow, we need to make it a loving place where the people are coming and their feet, they are so comfortable. They are welcome no matter what color they are. No matter what kind of clothes they are dressing. No matter what kind of language they are speaking. Just open up and say, brother, you are welcome to the house. Let us have a coffee together. Get the telephone number. Say, sister, can I give you a call? We can pray together. If there is anything you need, just give me a call. The early church was built by the people like that. Those who care for other people. On that time, the telephone was not there. On that time, the SMS was not there. On that time, the Facebook was not there. But the people, they were so connected in our time. Can you see that? I believe in our church, in our age, we can be more connected than their time. Amen. Because we have all the facility of connection. Come on, somebody. We have all the facility of connection, of connecting one another. And I want to say to people, what kind of world we're living in? Amen. I just want to have my own space. What kind of life you are living? You know, some people are saying to them, if you want to speak to people, what we need to do, we need to build a monastery. Somewhere in the forest there, where no one is there, you can just live with the monkey, with all those animals, then no one will be there. As long as you are living, you need the people around you. We need to bring the spirit of loneliness. I'm in a church but I'm alone. I feel lost. Please be open, a place of fellowship. A place where the people that come, they think they are so loved by the people. A place where the people that found that come, they feel like they are so, they were so concerned about others. Not about me. I'm coming to change my attitude. I don't want to talk to anyone in the church. I feel like I don't want to talk to anyone. Come on, that's not godly. Be friendly. Amen. Look at everybody say, never be friendly. Now look at everybody say, never be friendly. Now look at them and say, never, never be friendly. Amen. Sister, now you're my neighbor. Be friendly. Amen. The fellowship. together. And number three, the Bible says, and they spend their life on prayer. Say prayer. Say prayer.
Prayer.
You know, some people, they like to talk. But when we get to pray, oh, Pastor, the prayer is taking too long now. Amen. But when it's about talking, never be too long. They can spend an hour and an hour, be connected in the rest of the world. YouTube, in the Facebook, and all those reason in the internet, they are connected. You can see some people 2 a.m., 3 a.m., they are connected. But when they talk about prayer, Pastor, let us pray. You will start to go. And so, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, someone. You'll understand about us. On Thursday, how many people come here on Thursday? Some people, they don't know no reason. Some people attend that for those work. Amen. But some people, they don't prefer watching television. That's an hour. There's one of the show on television. I don't miss it. Hey, Lord, have mercy. Amen. The Bible says they spend their time in prayer. Say prayer. Say neighbor, you need to pray. Say neighbor, stop watching more TV. Learn how to pray. Come on, somebody. Amen. Amen. Especially young people, I don't see fire. What's wrong with you young people? Let me see. Let me hear your name now, but I know all of you your name now. What's wrong with you? Why you don't come on Thursday prayer? Esther, you don't come on Thursday prayer, why? Divine, you don't come on Thursday prayer, why? Maria, Jeff, Priscilla, why you don't come on Thursday prayer? Phil, you're looking at me. You don't come on Thursday prayer, why? I didn't ask you to say to me anything, I just asked you a question. You keep your answer, you keep your answer. My goodness, listen to me, Robbie, don't be come on prayer on Thursday, yet be young. Because it says you're not young anymore. I didn't ask you to listen to me a question. Amen. It's about prayer. Say prayer.
Prayer.
I believe if all of us will come together in prayer, this place will shake. Amen. Glory. When we come on Thursday prayer, when we come on Thursday prayer, I ask you, beg for your boy to come sometime. Amen. Only person, the moment the youth come on Thursday prayer, is this one. But most of young people, I don't get you. You pray. You know, some people, when I go to visit them, I'm sleeping. Wake up. I'm tired, Pastor. You didn't do anything sensible. I'm there, Pastor Peter. Hey, Lord, have mercy. I don't call by your name. You know yourself what I'm talking about. Since he knows, Pastor Peter talking to me because I know that after he will call, because you said to me that, yes, I'm already saying yes, I'm saying to you. Say prayer.
Prayer.
Say prayer.
Prayer.
We get fire through prayer. Amen.
Amen.
We get power through prayer.
Amen.
And if we expect Him to take our possession, we have to be men and women of prayer. If we expect Him, our church, the church of deliverance and the healing and the prophecy, we have to be men and women of prayer. Amen.
Amen.
If we get to pray, the healing will take place. If we get to pray, the deliverance will take place. If we begin to pray, the life of many will change through prayer. And the Bible says, every church, they were so dedicated, they were so committed to the life of prayer. Fasting and prayer was easier for them. You know, a lot of people, when we begin to speak about fasting and prayer, you will not know that they are under medication. Pastor, you know, I have to drink my medication, and the doctor said to me this. and I need to eat something. That's where the devil. All those days, I don't hear anything about under the delegation. But when somebody said to me, Pastor, I try one day and I just get to shake my body. I feel like I'm dying. You don't die, come on, amen. Try even one day of fasting. Try one day. Okay, let me say this. How many, if you miss this verse, you miss this year? Not those are married, but those are not yet married. Those who want to get married, don't be embarrassed. Raise your hand. They don't speak to your life. Who's the one expecting to get married? Don't scare. Maria! It's so early for you, Maria. My goodness. I'm about to pray for you. No, I only want based on always. Amy. Okay. You are all 1, 2, 3, 4 people. Esther, don't forget. Okay. No, don't worry, I'll pray for you. I trust, I'll pray for you. You need to be a good man. Yes. You are my daughter. Believe me, Esther, you marry a good man.
Amen.
You'll marry a good man.
Amen.
Good looking like Pastor Ben. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And last one. Can you just read the last one, Zoe? Just real quick now because I'll just stop here now. Because I'll keep preaching about this next day, next Sunday too. Let's read it from verse 43. You know when you read, the same chapter 3 in church. You are in 42, verse 42, going 43.
Everyone was filled with awe and many wonders and miraculous signs were done by the apostles. All the believers were together and had everything in common.
Just stop there. Let me stop here now. The Bible says the fear of the Lord was upon your life. Amen. The fear of the Lord. You know, there's a lot of Christians who come to church, they don't fear God. I don't get it. God is not, there's someone you need to let down. You need to be radical with your faith. And I will say, and the fear come upon every soul. And the fear of the Lord caused many wonders. The Bible says, and the fear come upon every soul. And the many wonders and the signs were done by the apostles. We are about to enter in our church the time of signs and wonders. And the problem is this. God needs a people who don't fear him. Living by the fear of the Lord. Now, what kind of change you and I we expect to be part of? I don't think you like the church where you go and no one greets you. Who accept you when you change and no one greets you and you are out like that? Who accept that kind of change? I don't believe so. What kind of change you want to be part of? I don't think you'll be part of the church where no one will call you. Who accept to be part of the church? No one care about you. You're just there by yourself and no one care about you. No. Number one, the church is a family. Amen. The church, we are the family of God. And we must take care of one another. I think you want to be a part of the church where people are so joyful. People are loving one another. People are working together. People are working as a team. People are so committed for the cause of the kingdom. No one is there to complain about all about me, but all is about God. What kind of change can you be part of? early church is our role model. We look at the church and we look at ourselves now. And we look at our church and we look at the church as a body. But I think with me, I want to be part of the church where the people are so open. One another. I want to be a church where the people are so joyful and caring of one another. I don't want to be part of the church people complaining, so wicked, people are so confused, people are so gossiping, putting their pastor down, putting their leader down. Hey, stop it! Get out of those things. I want to be part of the church where the people are able to support one another. Calling one another and say, hey, pastor, I'm here for you. We can pray together. You know that pastor is a human being?
Yes.
Oh, come on, somebody, man. Pastor, human. I'm not an angel from the heaven. I can feel. I can be sad. I can be angry. I can be confused. I need someone to say, pastor, we are together. We are praying for you. Come on, somebody. Why does he have to pray for everyone? And no one calls for me and say, pastor, don't be worried. We are together in prayer. We are praying for you. Oh, come on, somebody. I'm a human. I need comfort sometimes. I want to make sure that some people are standing with me. Say, pastor, even though no one is there, but we are there together. Come on, somebody. Come on. Are we together? And I believe that a church you want to be part of too. You can't be in a family where every day the people are fighting. Every day the people are so confused. Anyway, you can't be part of that from here. I want to be out of this place. Can we make our church a welcoming place? Come on, somebody, man. Can we make our church when we come together a welcoming place? That if someone shows up tomorrow, say, I want to miss that place. I'll be part of that family. Can we be involved in the church? Not only Brother Danny and the band after the church, running around the Brother Wanda, cleaning the church, and some people standing outside there, you want me to call you? Come on. If it's your own house, no one will tell you to clean up. You will do it by yourself. Come on. Be part of the family. The church is a family. Find something to do. Commit yourself to it. Come on, somebody. When we say, like, we have a flyer now, we are sharing it. Hey, be excited about this. Hey, go and tell your friend, this is what happened in our family. Tell your friend you're a good pastor, a good person. I'm good looking, I'm cool. Oh, come on, somebody. My daughter, be what you think. I'm not good looking. Oh, come on. This boy said that our pastor's so funny. Come say, my pastor will make you laugh. I promise you, if you bring your friend, you'll laugh. Never you disappoint with me. Everyone who comes close to me become my friend by force. I'll force myself and say, okay, we are friends now, yes. Come on, somebody, man. Can we begin to report good news of one another? Telling someone about how good Robert is, how good Melvin is, how good Danny is, how good God is, how good this place is, and stop criticizing one another, putting the people down. Begin to lift one another up now.
Amen.
Oh, come on. Listen, make our church a welcoming environment, a safe place. Tell them about how our musicians are so good. Tell them we have a new team of musicians who come to join our church now. They are singing good. Just tell them how good those people they are. Very hard, I don't like it because I'm in our church now. They began to sing like that now because I've been there singing for a long time ago, but tell me that's come now and sing. Stop it! Get out of those things. Amen. Say we are family.
We are family.
Say we are family.
We are family.
Say we are family.
We are family.
And we are building the kingdom of our Father.
We are building the kingdom of our Father.
Come on, church. Amen.
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 Amen. How are we together?
Yes.
I believe that together we can do it. I believe together we can make a difference. And those who think like we are going back, they'll be surprised that we are moving forward.
Amen.
Come on, somebody. We are moving forward. Now, this is what I want to say. Say, my weakness,
my weakness.
From today,
from
today.
We are divorced.
We are divorced.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Say my weakness.
My weakness.
My big mouth.
My big mouth.
From today.
From today.
We are divorced.
We are divorced.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Say from today.
From today.
I commit myself. To speak good.
To speak good.
To speak good. For my brother and my sister. In Jesus' name. Say
from today.
I commit my life. To speak good. For my brother.
And my sister.
In Jesus' name. Come on, somebody. Say
from today,
I commit myself to serve the Lord and be part of the family, regardless what, in Jesus' name. Say with me, Lord Jesus, fill my heart with your spirit and your joy, in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name.
Jesus.
In Jesus' name.
Jesus.
Say, Lord Jesus,
Lord Jesus,
open my eyes.
Show me the need of the church.
And let me be the answer. In Jesus' name. That's not clear at this word. Please, my friend. Be committed for the cause. Be committed for the cause. Thank you, Lord. Father, we thank you. We give you praise and the glory and the honor for your word. Father, we are called to be committed for that cause. And I pray for every single person here, Lord God. Let your spirit be upon them. That they be able, Lord God, to commit themselves to the cause. In the name of Jesus. I declare for all those who raise up your hand, Lord God, for the marriage. By the sound of my voice, Father, before we reach this year, for those who are ready, Father, let the testimony be given to them. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I say, let the testimony be given to them in Jesus' mighty name. Father, let this place, Lord God, be a place where the people are not defeated. Where the people are not defeated, Lord God. But where the people are come with joy.
Yes.
And act of fear, Lord God, of love in your presence. And growth take place, Lord God. In Jesus' mighty name. Father, we thank you. We give you praise, mighty God, for everything you are doing now. And everything you are about to do. In Jesus' name we pray. And the people of God say,
amen.
And the people of God say,
amen.
And as I said to you, please, you have about